Welcome back to the Wildflower series. Today we learn about the other bonnets. The other bonnets, you say? Yep, there's more than just blue ones. Also, hang around to the end to learn a great legend about these other colors. In 1982, a Texas naturalist named Carol Abbott had a dream of planning the design of the Texas state flag comprised entirely of the state flower, the blue bonnet, to celebrate the 1986 Texas sesquicentennial. Lots of work went into finding and producing the colors needed, blue, white, and red, to represent our state flag. The blue bonnets, of course, were readily available. The white bonnet was familiar to most local botanists, yet still unknown to the majority of Texans. Photographers always treasure the opportunity to find a rare white albino blue bonnet nestled among the blues. Abbott considered scientific production of the pink and eventually red a bit far-fetched. This great plantsman had roamed the fields of Texas his entire life and had seen only three pink blue bonnet plants. In searching for the pink strain, people were told to collect only seeds from pinks in large groups so that natural selection would have already bred some of the blue out of the pinks. However, the pinks were indeed so rare that only four locations throughout the entire state were reported. The motherlode of pinks was found within the city limits of San Antonio. For every color in nature, there exist hues or shades of that color. For instance, within the pink bonnet, there should exist a series of shades of darker pink and eventually red. Another spectrum of colors should exist when blue color shades are mixed with dark pink or red to create lavender or maroon. All of these colors by law are legally the state flower. The additional colors of the state flower were not genetically created by man. These colors have existed for as long as blue bonnets have bloomed and were created, in fact, by God. The legend of the white and pink bonnets. One spring day, two children scampered through a field of wildflowers near San Antonio on their way to the old mission church. They were followed by their slower grandmother dressed in black. "Mamacita, here is a white flower with all the blue ones," the excited girl cried. "Those are blue bonnets," her grandmother explained, "and sometimes, very seldom, there is a white one among them. Some even say the Lone Star, the Texas flag, was fashioned after one amongst a field of blue." The little boy looked down at his feet. "But what about this pink one?" The small group studied the pure pink blue bonnet a moment before the grandmother turned to the children and spoke. "When I myself was a little girl, my grandmother told me of a special story about these rare flowers. They seem to only grow downstream from the Mission Alamo, and that is because of something which happened here many years ago. It was when Texas was not part of the United States, but only a remote province of Mexico. The Americanos had not been settled here for long, but trade was busy, and we all had hopes of a golden future for our country. Our family owned a fine house and farm near the old cathedral. My papa would rise early, take his tools, and work the land before the day grew too hot. Then, after the noon siesta, everyone would begin to wake in the cool of the dusk. The adults would take a bath in the clear river, while we children splashed in the shallows. Everyone would dance, eat, and visit until late into the evening. Sometimes there were Americanos who came to celebrate with us, but their talk always turned to politics. The men were angered because the Constitution had been overthrown by a terrible Mexican dictator. The men were upset and the women were afraid. Then came that bitter spring, when we learned that the dictator was on his way to our city with many troops. Papa was torn between joining the Americanas to fortify the old mission compound and fear for his family. He decided to hide us in the countryside, and every time I look at the ruins of the mission chapel, I remember the fear we lived in during that time. Day and night, we heard the cannons and rifles firing in the distance. The brave new Texans fought long and hard, but in the end, were overwhelmed by the Mexican troops. After the shots finally ended, we crept silently home in the darkness. Mama and Papa were thankful that our lives had been spared, but it broke their hearts to learn of the many who had lost their lives in that terrible battle. Mama often cried when she passed the homes where friends had fallen. One day, several years later, I found her putting a pink wildflower in a vase beside the statue of the Virgin. She told me that she had found it near the river where it had once been white, but so much blood had been shed, it had taken the tint of it. The grandmother paused. "That is why you will only find the pink ones near the river, within sight of the old mission," she said. "So remember, the next time you see a pink bonnet, it's not only a pretty flower, but a symbol for the struggle to survive and a memory of those who died so that Texas could be free."
How can you help me to keep bringing you great creative content? There's a link for that in the description below.
And don't forget, enjoy the journey. Lily Gypsy Child.